Hello to the people of Sangwal, Kortalim, Kansaldim, Arosim, Isorsim, Welsam, and Kelosim. And also hello to the people of whole of Goa. My name is Vishal Gajanan Naik, and I am from the village of Sangwal in Kortalim constituency. I have done my education in Diploma in Computer Engineering, followed by a 5 years of law degree. With your support, I am contesting the upcoming 2022 Vidhan Sabha elections from Kortalim constituency. I am not affiliated to and do not subscribe to ideology of any political party or NGO. For last 10 years, we have elected candidates of Bharatiya Janata Party to represent us in the Goa Assembly. And what have they done for protecting interests of the people of Goa? Absolutely nothing. Recently, when a resolution was introduced in the Goa Assembly to scrap the coal project, as our elected representative, Alina Saldana was duty bound to remain present in the assembly during the voting process. And if the people of Kortalim constituency wanted a coal project, Alina should have voted saying that yes, we want a coal project. In case the people of Kortalim did not want the coal project, Alina Saldana should have voted saying we don't want the coal project. But what did Alina do? She just ran away. She remained absent for the voting process. I will never run away like Alina ran away. Vote me, and I will fight in the assembly to protect the interests of the people of Kortalim and interests of the whole of Goa. My major issue for the 2022 election is MPT, Murmunga Port Trust, which is a central government company. Goa government, Pramod Sawant, or the Goans in general do not have any control over MPT. Pramod Sawant has declared that he will reduce coal by 50%, which is a blatant lie. Because Pramod Sawant has no power over what and how much MPT imports or exports, simply because MPT doesn't come under the Goa government. Bringing MPT under the Goa government will also help us Goans to generate jobs and business opportunities in tourism industries within MPT. Further, the various issues faced by Goans because of MPT, such as the coal pollution, destruction of eco-sensitive coastline, dredging, fishermen's and rapunkas issue, will be solved by us Goans without any external help. I need your vote to bring MPT back to the Goans. Many people ask me, why don't you join the Revolutionary Goans, as I am also a Goan. Well, I had made a promise to myself that I will not join any political party or NGO. As RGE will also be fielding their candidate in Kortalim constituency, some of my well-wishers have expressed an apprehension that RGE will be a competition to me in Kortalim. But I want to clear this doubt. I want to tell you that if any political party, Bharatiya Janata Party, Aam Aadmi, or Revolutionary Goans, field a candidate much more capable than myself, then people should vote for him. But if you feel that I am much more capable candidate than any of the other candidates to go in the assembly and fight for the interests of the people of Kortalim constituency, and also fight for the people of the whole of Goa, then do vote for me. Then vote for Vishal Gajanan Naik. This 2022 election, the people of the villages of Sangwal, Kortalim, Kansaldim, Arosim, Isorsim, Welsam, and Kelosim, we all have to make it sure that we all vote for only one candidate. Because if we divide our votes, for example, let's say 7,000 people vote for Alina Saldana, 3,000 for Aam Aadmi, and 10,000 votes for 2-3 independent candidates, and let's say 4,000 votes for Revolutionary Goans, then what we all will be getting again in 2022 is only Alina Saldana. So every one of us, 30,000 people of the villages of Sangwal, Kortalim, Kasalim, Arosim, and Kelosim, we have to make up our mind and vote for only one candidate. May it be belonging to Bharatiya Janata Party, Aam Aadmi, Revolutionary Goans, और माई सेल्फ विशाल गजानन नायक, बट एवरी वन डू वॉट फॉर ओनली वन कैंडिडेट।